As early as 1671, there was a scientist. His name was Robert Boyle. Robert Boyle and his team scientists, together working with acids and metals like iron. In the process of experimenting, they used to produce a gas. But the scientists, including Robert, they did not know the name of the gas and the properties of the gas. Later, 100 years, a scientist is named Henry Cavendish. He put his efforts to know the name and the properties of the gas. He put efforts to know the properties and the nature of the gas. And he found a specific properties of that gas, and he gave a name as hydrogen. And the hydrogen gas has been given number one place in the list of elements present in the history of chemistry. Okay, students, this is how hydrogen gas was discovered. Students, hydrogen gas is a colorless, odorless gas. So this gas is produced when acids react with metals like iron. Not only iron, you can take any other metals as well. Okay, let us see that how hydrogen gas is produced by doing simple experiment. Okay, students, here what you have to take is, you have to take a natural acid, say for example lemon juice consists of what type of acid in it? Citric acid. Okay, along with lemon juice, citric acid, you have to take different metal materials like copper, zinc, magnesium, brass, iron, and aluminium. Here I am writing, and aluminium. You have to take these metal materials and you have to take one acid, one type of acid, that is citric acid. This is natural acid. Okay, students, so how to do the experiment? You have to take natural citric acid in 6 test tubes. Yeah, you have to take lemon juice in all of these test tubes. What you have to take? Citric acid only. Now what you have to do? You have to take copper, a sample bit of copper, and drop in the test tube 1, and zinc in test tube 2, and magnesium in test tube 3, okay, next brass in test tube 4, iron in test tube 5, aluminium in test tube 6, and let it stand for few hours. After few hours, you observe that. After few hours, what will you observe? You have to set it aside for few hours. After few hours, you will observe some gas is produced and some fumes coming out of the test tubes you will observe. Okay, students, gas, some fumes coming out you will observe here. This gas is nothing but hydrogen. This gas is nothing but what? Hydrogen gas. And we have to confirm that whether it is hydrogen gas or not. Here there is a confirmation test. What is there? There is a confirmation test. How to confirm? You have to lit a burning splinter or burning match stick. You have to take a burning match stick. You know what is this? Burning match stick. And this fire, this flame, you have to slowly bring close to the mouth of the test tube and observe. What will you observe when you bring this burning splinter close to the mouth of the test tube? You have to bring this burning splinter close to the mouth of the test tube from which the gas is being produced. See and observe then. The burning splinter puts off. This burning splinter puts off by making a sound, pop sound. Pop. Students, the burning splinter puts off by making a sound. How? Sound. By making pop sound. So this confirms that hydrogen gas. Okay, the gas is hydrogen gas. Like this, you can understand how hydrogen gas is produced. Okay, with acids and metal reactions, there hydrogen gas is produced. In the earlier class, in the last class, I have taught you about acids should not be stored in metal containers because of what? Acids are corrosive in nature. They damage the metal containers by producing hydrogen. You know, by producing what? Hydrogen. So we should not store acids in metal containers like this. We can understand. Okay, students. And next, let us talk about an experiment with eggshell. Egg, you know, after you boil egg, if you want to eat the egg, what will you break? You will break shell of the egg. That's eggshell. So here, what you have to do is, let us talk about what? Experiment with eggshell. And acid, eggshell and acid. So acids are many in the nature. One of them, let us take now, one of them is, let us take nitric acid. Nitric acid, and you add this nitric acid to eggshell, or else you take a bit of eggshell and take one test tube, take nitric acid in the test tube, What is this? Nitric acid. And take eggshell. What is the composition of eggshell? Do you know what is the composition of eggshell? Calcium, carbonate. Composition of eggshell is calcium carbonate and acid. One of the acids is nitric acid we are taking in this experiment. Take some nitric acid, some amount of nitric acid in the test tube, and take some parts of eggshell and drop them in the nitric acid which is in the test tube. And nitric acid plus calcium carbonate, these two together react and they produce new products. Like, what are those new products produced after nitric acid and calcium carbonate react? They produce calcium nitrate and carbon dioxide and water. We are not, these are the products, these are the reactants. So when nitric acid and calcium carbonate, its calcium carbonate is nothing but eggshell. When these two react together, then they produce, what are these reactants, right? And after these reactants react, there some other products are produced. These are reactants and these are products. You know, between the reactants and products, you should put a symbol, this rightward arrow. Okay, this indicates it's going to produce, the reactants are going to produce. This means that, okay, calcium nitrate and carbon dioxide and water are produced in this reaction. So this is the reaction with eggshell and nitric acid. Students, as soon as you drop the bits of eggshell in acid, you will find some bubbles forming around the eggshell. Okay, bubbles, and then after you drop a complete egg in the acid, in any acid, after some time you will find that a squishy bouncing egg. Okay, it's a soft, that becomes very soft because the calcium carbonate reacts and that produces calcium nitrate and carbon dioxide in water. Like this you can understand how acids and eggshell react. Okay.